Hey yo, hey YouTube, a lot of people bitching about Castlevania 64 and Castlevania Legacy of Darkness, and I want to say a couple of things. First of all, it's not really a bad game. Now I know that the Angry Video Game Nerd basically go down on both of this game, but I know that he just doing this for fun and it's not really serious, but anyway, I want to speak about the game. I doing a Castlevania marathon, so basically I play all the Castlevania game, and I want to say a couple of things about this game. First of all, the AV music in Castlevania 64 and Castlevania Legacy of Darkness. Now, yeah, it's not in every place in the game you get the music, but an important part of the game, you do get music in the game. Second of all, the camera issue. Yes, the camera can be annoying in some part, but in most of the part in the game, it's okay camera, and you basically have three different camera, one for the bosses and two regular that you can turn between them. The control, it's not exactly perfect, but it's not the baddest that I ever play, so it's okay control. Now in Castlevania 64 you basically have two different story, like basically in Resident Evil 2, so you can play two different character, and every one of the character have its own story. In Castlevania Legacy of Darkness, you basically have four story, but one of them is more like a bonus. Now a lot of people don't understand what the difference between Castlevania Legacy of Darkness and Castlevania 64. Now, Castlevania 64 is the fourth game. It's not really called Castlevania 64, but everybody calls it like that. In Castlevania 64, you have two characters that you can play. Everyone with its own story and its own ability. Now, in Castlevania Legacy of Darkness, first of all, they put in memory team support, that if you have the 8 memory, so you supposedly can get a little better graphic. But besides that, you have two new story in this world in the game. One of them you play like a man wolf or something, or wolfman or whatever. Now, this part of the game, it's basically a prequel for Castlevania 64, even that it came after. So, yeah, you can play it. Okay, it's the same thing, but different character, different story, different ability. After you beat this game with the man wolf, you can play some bonus stage that you supposed to find, I think, six kids in the board of the game, and you have some time to finish that, and then you play basically Castlevania 64. So yeah, so it's something like that. It's difficult to say what it is. It's not really a remake, no, it's a prequel, but you have the same game after that. So yeah, and it's in the same world of the game and with the same enemy basically. So yeah, but overall for Castlevania game, it's not the best Castlevania game, of course, but it's also not the creepier of them all. So yeah, and now a lot of people trying to compare it to Castlevania Symphony of the Night, and Symphony of the Night, yeah, it's a much more better game. But Symphony of the Night is a 2D game. And for Konami to make 2D game, it probably was much more easier in this time, the 3D game only evolve. So yeah, but I play both of the game and it is enjoyable. Castlevania 64 and Castlevania Legacy of Darkness, they are an enjoyable game. They're not great game, they're not even close to Zelda 64 or Zelda Majora's Mask or in the PlayStation Castlevania Symphony of the Night, of course, or other game. But it is okay game for its time. Now, for today's standard, yeah, it's crap. But let's face it, even Symphony of the Night, in my point of view, for this generation, it's not exactly good. So yeah. And I'm sorry for all the people that beat, oh, Castlevania Symphony of the Night is the best. No, it's not the best. They have better game after Symphony of the Night. Yeah. So anyway, what I want to say is, you can try it, you can play it. It's not close to today's standard of game, but it's okay game. It's not a bad game. It's not a creepy game like a lot of people call it. It's not suck. For Nintendo 64, it's okay game. So thank you for listening. Goodbye, YouTube.